Fantastic, great. Thank you, Aditya. Inspired by this batch, the third year student Sanchita, who is getting this scholarship today. Once again, we're going to give these scholarships next year as well. And the second proud recipient is Ms. Ankita, once again a first year student, and she's there.
Hello, Beta.
Once again, a round of applause for the students and the batch of the 1826 batch. Congratulations for doing this for us. Thank you so much. So we have another first today. One of you first, T. Rohit, Amir, Aarti, Abhijit, Kanupriya, Office of ENRPG, and my co-editor, Dr. Ravi Kiran. We are ready with the first edition of the newsletter. This newsletter will be a biannual edition covering all major achievements of our faculty, students, staff, and alumni over a period of 6 months. We're going to unveil the first edition of Thapar Times. That is what the newsletter is titled. And I would request this team gathering to please do the honors and unveil the first copy. I request the students to please take the copies down and also distribute it amongst the alumni. Thank you very much. This is Thapar Times for you and carries the news chronicled over the period of last 6 months, January to June 2013. And it is going to be, the next issue is going to be due in February. And we'll be putting up this newsletter in the form of a PDF copy.
And we will make that available to the students. So this year we could only generate funds for two scholarships. Next time we are sure, we will at least give 4 scholarships. And if everybody's courses, this can be more than that. Thank you very much.
For the time. And he has been a kind guy throughout his association with this.
Honorable Chairman, Board of Governors, Mr. S.M. Trahan, distinguished alums of Thapar University, ladies and gentlemen, it's a very proud moment for us at Thapar University to be amongst you, our old alums from various batches. The nation today demands basically employable youth, and for creating employable youth, we need different type of feedback from different areas, industry, businesses, those who are acting as entrepreneurs. And I feel a very strong bonding is required between the university and the alums so as to carry forward the great legacy of this institute. I would very strongly urge you that in areas of support to the present students, with a view to guide them, you should give powerful support to our initiatives, whether it is project semesters, summer semesters. I know many of you would have retired, but still, your advice will go a long way in terms of turning the students as better citizens of this country. We have built up a new campus, which will start very in the near future. Dehrabasi. I'm reminded when people said the type of facilities which are available at Patiala, they are no longer. We are not seeing that in Dehrabasi. Or the type of problems which our alums faced when we started this great institution in 56. I wish from advice from you, it is not the infrastructure only, but it is the type of the students at that time. Today also we are looking forward to the same situation, a great faculty, a great institute, and I look forward that the alums will give full support. Not only we are talking of money, but basically in terms of guiding our students more employable, more productive resources as far as the nation is concerned. In these words, I must thank you once again.
You to introduce the chief guest of this liminary function, Shri S.N. Prehan ji. Shri S.N. Prehan is a gold medalist mechanical engineering graduate from Birla Institute of Technology, Ranchi. He has a master's degree in operational research from State University of New York at Stony Brook, USA. He successfully completed AMP program at the Harvard Business School, Boston, USA. He joined Crompton Greaves Limited in 1983 and over the years held several positions of responsibility. He was the managing director of Crompton Greaves Limited from the year May 2000 to May 2011. He is now the vice chairman of Crompton Greaves Limited and is the executive chairman of Avanta Power and Infrastructure Limited. Also, he is the chairman board of governors of Thapar University. Mr. S.N. Prehan has worked in various capacities with CII, IEEMA, NIMA, and PMA. He is the past chairman of Western Region of Confederation of Indian Industry, CII.
Esteemed gathering of the alumni of this institute, dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, faculty, students, a very good afternoon to all of you. It's an honor to stand before you today in the shadows of these beautiful portals on this occasion of Alumni Day. And I have a personal attachment to you when I heard your roll number, because I am also different institute, so I could have brought up a 62 batch. And my roll number was F17 by 62. And F was because at that time, there used to be an engineering course for 5 years because there was a change in the country from 11th to 12th. There was higher secondary and 10 plus 2. So there was used to be a P for preliminary, those who went for 5 years, and F for first year. So F, so it wasn't Kurukshetra or F for other F, so I have clarified what the F stands for. And it was a real honor to see all of you today, and I can specially link myself to you because I missed mine going to the institute, my alma mater, last year. And once again, a hearty welcome to your alma mater, welcome to Harvard University. As I know, such an event is being celebrated for the first time on this campus to honor the founders of this great institute, along with honoring you as the alumni of this institute. And particularly 62 and 63 batch who are uniting again. To serve the university as its chairman of board is a new responsibility for me because I have spent all my 39 years of working till 11 in industry. And hence, rather than me contributing to the university, to be frank, I'm learning a lot from the university. And there's a lot of opportunity for the university to learn from each of the alumni here. We are indeed the inheritors of a great legacy, the legacy of the vision of our great founding father, late Lala Karamchand Thapar, and the philanthropist attitude of his illustrious son, late Mr. Lalit Mohan Thapar. Fortunately, given our present circumstances, it's a legacy marked by times of dramatic transition and transformation. And we are very fortunate to have a very dedicated and forward-looking Shri Gautam Thapar to lead us as our president at the helm. Thapar University has never been a status quo university. It has always pushed the envelope and moved ahead. Thapar University, as it stands today, is associated with the strength of the creative capacity of its students and the faculty in reinvention and revaluation, and the far-reaching impact of its alumni. Rome, as they say, was not built in a day. 57 years for a university is not a very long period. The other day, with some faculty members, I was at Trinity College, Dublin, and they said we are 400 years old. So an educational institution is always learning, and Thapar University is a young university. It has been the collective efforts of all you alumni, faculty and staff of this institute that we stand at this enviable position today. But we indeed need to look forward. The work of institute building does not stop here. We cannot build an institute just for today. Like the artist, we must be prepared to walk away from the canvas. The university cannot and should not create every program and area of study its proud legacy has included. Rather, it should focus on its set of core strengths and competencies. That means that what you as a student specifically studied may or may not be within the future focus of the university. As the faculty sits down to draft a future course of action for this university. I would like each one of you to contribute to the cause by providing valuable inputs from your enriching experience. But what will be true is what has always been true. If you put a group of creative and passionate students in a small room, that room looks very good. But if you put a student in a room with a talented and empowered faculty, great things happen. That is what Thapar University has been doing and shall continue to do. Empower the faculty and students alike. We need both together. Where should Thapar University be going from here? Before I come to the concrete where it should be going, let me give you a story. It's really not a story, it's a fact, which I read very recently in one of the magazines. The name of the story is Billy Graham's Suit. Billy Graham was 91 years old. In January 2000, the leaders of Charlotte, North Carolina, USA, decided to honor the son of Charlotte. And they wanted him to come and have lunch and be honored at the lunch. Billy was a bit hesitant